Hi guys, it's Grace Pamela at Summerana.com, and today I'm going to show you how to use the dark and moody presets in Adobe Camera Raw, also known as ACR. So the first thing I did was I uploaded an image that I wanted to work on, and now I'm going to upload it into Adobe Camera Raw. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to Filter, and then Camera Raw Filter. Okay, so here I have my image, and here are all these settings that you can work with. To use the presets, I'm going to go to this little guy right there and select presets. And here, you can upload your presets. And we have another tutorial that shows how to do that. So the dark and moody ones are super simple to use. What you can do is just kind of select through to see what kind of exposure you want. There's plus exposure, which goes up higher, and then there's negative, which goes down lower. You can either use them right in the beginning, if your image is obviously too underexposed or overexposed, or you can go and use those later. So this image is pretty well exposed. So what you're going to want to do then is go through the base presets, and you can go ahead and click around to see what would work best for your image. Every image is going to be different. So one might look horrible on one image, and another might look like the same preset might look amazing on another image. So it totally depends. And then you can also go in later and adjust it however you'd like. And I will show you how to do that. So I'm just kind of going through the different base presets. It completely depends on what you want to accomplish with your image and also what your style might be. Now, keep in mind, for some of these, it might seem dark, like this one, for example. But that's why we have our adjustments that we can make. So you can brighten it up as you see fit. Okay, so this is an example preset that I will show you. It was mudslide, so you can kind of go through and see the rest as well. And if it's too bright, you can darken it also. So some might be too dark, some might be too bright. It totally depends. Okay, so once you have your base that you like, you can also go through and you can adjust some of these other small details, such as add hazy light, save highlights. So that might be if it's too bright in some areas, or if it's too dark, you might want to brighten your whites. You can add a color pop. You can also reset the mood, which is like the toning. And then you can also add grain, sharpness. You can make it smooth, more of like a painterly finish, if that's what you prefer. And then also vignette. And you can level the image. This one might not always work like as needed, but it usually does a pretty good job depending on your image and what it contains. Okay, so it's really easy to use these. And then in addition, if you want to, you can also add on top of your presets. So by going in here, you can adjust it a little bit more by the settings, however you need to, because each preset, it's not always going to be one and done. It can be, because, you know, as you can see, there are lots of really pretty presets. But just so you're aware, you know, you can go back in here and add a little bit more detail or sharpening, because your image might not be as sharp. Maybe you want to add more, or maybe you want to adjust the temperature, the white balance. You can go ahead and select, like, around in here. To adjust that. So you really have like full control over how you want your image to look as dark and moody as you want it. Or maybe you don't want it as dark and moody, but you want a little hint of it. Completely up to you. So you can go to the adjustments here. You can add a spot removal so you can heal there. You know, there's lots of options that you can do. But here are the presets, and this is how the presets work. They are lots of fun to play with. The other thing that I wanted to show you as well is what you can do is you can select okay for this image, and you can see here now you have your before and after. So you can go here and then in your history to see the before and after. So if you don't like it, you can go to window, history, or you can just like reopen it. So what you can do is you can save it, and then if you wanted to, you can upload it again with this filter with the preset on, and then you can go through and you can re-upload it with the effects on, and then you can add another preset on top of it, and that's a really neat way to double the effect that you have, or if you want more of an intense preset and look to it. Otherwise, you can add another preset, a different preset on top of that preset. I hope I'm making sense. But this way, it's fun because you can add multiple presets and you can combine different ones, if that makes sense. So yeah, that's what I wanted to show you, how to use the dark and moody presets in Adobe Camera Raw. I hope this was helpful, and I hope you guys will have lots of fun creating your dark and moody images. I know I have lots of fun using them. All right, bye guys.